You go outside, you take a great landscape shot, you return back to your home, you open your gazillion megapixels file on your nice monitor and you want to pull your hair out of your head. Because why? There are a lot of black spots of dust, debris, anything you can imagine. And you're freaking out because you don't know how to clean up this mess. It's going to probably be too hard, right? No, because I'm going to show you how to solve exactly this problem by using Affinity Photo and the amazing retouching tools it offers. So stay tuned on how we're going to be using Affinity Photo in order to clean up our images and make them awesome again. Make them awesome again. It's like make America great again, but yeah, never mind. Cut to the intro, cut to the intro. Hello, this is Stratos Agiani from illumius.com with my funny Greek accent. Thank you very much for being here and putting up with me and my accent as well. Today's free tutorial is all about Affinity Photo again, and I'm going to show you how you can retouch your photos in order to remove any dust, sensor dust, lens dust, specks, or unwanted objects, you name it, we can actually erase it just like Arnold Schwarzenegger in Eraser, or not Eraser, in... Yeah, you know, this movie where he erased people. Okay, so we're going to be using some very interesting techniques in a non-destructive way in this tutorial, and I'm going to show you how to use the retouching tools in order to erase anything that can ruin your photo. And this is especially useful as a skill because if you go to a place that you can't go back again very soon, or if you go to a place like the photo, like the place in the photo you are going to see right now, and the place is going to be a lot different in a week or two, and you can't take the same shot, well, you are good luck and good hands, because I'm going to show you how to save exactly these photos. So without any further delay, let me shut up and let's go into Affinity Photo to watch, see, and learn about how to retouch our landscape shots and remove any specks that might destroy it. That must be the longest intro I ever made, right? Leave me a comment down below. Okay, as you can see here, I have a photo that I'm preparing for a future tutorial on how to go from a photo like this over here to a photo like this. I'm going to be talking about color grading. I'm going to show you my custom process for editing landscapes like this. So subscribe to our YouTube channel if you want to get notified when we release this video. But what I wanted to show you today is how you can get rid of artifacts that destroy your photo. So you can see here we have a lot of things going on. This is a before and after, before and after. Actually, this is a before, if I want to say it correctly, and this is the after, so it makes more sense, I know. Now, here's the problem. As you can see here, I was shooting with a large aperture, and every speck of dust on my sensor and on my camera and on my lens is visible. And not only that, we had within the reflections in the water some specks, some broken branches, and we had a lot of, let's say, things that distract our attention. And fortunately or unfortunately, if you are shooting with a mirrorless camera like I do, when you open up this pack, let's say, to change your lenses, the sensor, because it doesn't have a mirror in front of it, is going to suck every dust that exists in the air like a magnet, and the dust is going to stick on your sensor and ruin every single shot of yours. So if you have mirrorless, I know the pain, the struggle of the dust is real, believe me. But Affinity Photo, fortunately, can make things a lot easier for us. So, how do we erase stuff like that? Well, it's very easy. First of all, let me deactivate all my adjustment layers over here in order to give you the original photo with the dust specks. And the first thing that you want to do when you open up a photo like this in within Affinity Photo and has a lot of dirt and spots that you want to remove, is to create a new pixel layer on top of your photo. So In order to make things a lot easier, let me get rid of all these layers, and as you can see now, all I have is my original photo and on top of it an empty pixel layer. And why I want to do that? I want to work on an empty pixel layer because if something goes wrong, I can delete it and I can go back to my original photo without losing anything. So it's a non-destructive way of correcting your photos. Now, once I have my pixel layer ready, I'm going to double click on its name and rename it, let's say spot removal. I think we're good to go now. And let's search for the very nice healing brush tool. Now, how this tool works? Very easily, of course, because I'm coming from Photoshop, it took me a while to get used to it, but it's really fast and it's really effective once you get the hang of it. So what you need to do, first of all, once you select the healing brush tool over here, is you need to go to opacity and make sure that it is at 100, flow is 100, and hardness is something like 25 to 50% depending on what you do. Because you don't want a hardness of 100, and why you don't want this? Because every correction you are going to make, it's going to show up in your photos like an ugly patch. For example, let me give you an example. I'm going to correct this and give me a second to sample all layers. I'm going to explain everything in a minute, just bear with me. So sometimes when you do, let's say, some corrections, you're going to see in this area, let me zoom in, a very ugly circle around the clown. So it's actually working like a stamp tool. It takes something from one area and it drops it on top of another area in order to hide something that you want to hide. For example, dust specks and black spots. But it looks very ugly because I have my hardness to 100. So what I want to do is I want to go around 25 to 50% depending on what you do. Okay, now that we have this out of the way, let's rewind a little bit and let's see the steps from the beginning. Step number one, I'm opening up the photo into Affinity Photo. Duh. Step number two, I create a new pixel layer on top of my background layer. Step number three, I'm selecting my healing brush tool and making sure that I have the opacity at 100, flow 100, hardness, let's start with 25%. And the most important step of all, plus setting, you want to make sure that the source is current layer and below. Because if you leave only the current layer, it's going to take from the empty pixel layer information and it's going to place it into another area of the empty pixel layer. So it will do absolutely nothing. For example, take a look. I'm going to try to correct this. Nothing happens because it's working on an empty layer. So this is why nothing is happening. So what you need to make sure is you need to make sure that this option over here from the source drop-down menu is set to current layer and below, and you're good to go. Now, how this tool works? It's very nice. And actually I love it more than Photoshop's, because in Photoshop, if you use the spot healing brush tool, you click on an area that you want to correct, but Photoshop decides from where it's going to draw material in order to make this correction. But within Affinity Photo, you can alt click, and this is the nice part, you can alt click in order to tell it from where it's going to take material and use material in order to make the correction. So for example, if I want to correct this spot over here, I don't want Affinity Photo to take from, let's say, the trees or from wherever the algorithm thinks needs to pull material from. I want to define the source area myself. And I can do this by alt-clicking within my frame. So alt-click here, it's going to draw material from here. And if I go over here, left-click and start painting, as you can see, voila, everything's corrected in a very nice and perfect way. I need to correct this thing, no problem. I'll click in this area, so it's going to draw material from this area and use this material to correct this dark large spot. And let's see, it works flawlessly. Very nice correction. Very nice. That reminds me of Borat. If you have seen the movie, you know what I'm talking about. So let's try some other corrections. I'll click here and I'm going to erase this spot and let's say dirt. I'll click here. I'm going to erase this spot. I'll click here. I'm going to erase this area. I'll click here and I'm going to erase this area. I'll click, erase, I'll click, erase. And let's see if we have anything else. Alt click, erase. Yes. Now, here's a pro tip. If you're going to do this kind of work, make sure you clean your monitor first, because your monitor might have some black spots. It might be also something that you're working on, let's say on a random Tuesday at 2 o'clock after midnight, and because you're so tired, you are actually trying to understand why the damn thing is not working. And it's only working because the black spot or the dust is not on your photo, it's on your actual monitor. It has happened to a friend, not me. Yeah, I can assure you that. Anyway, let's move on. Let's see what other spots we have here that needs correction. Okay, now here, for example, is the trap. This is a spot that I think exists on my frame, but actually it exists on my monitor. I'll click here to get the, oops, I'll click here to get rid of this area. Maybe I will try something like this, maybe this spot, maybe this one, and maybe this one as well. And if you see now the before and after, look what a huge difference this process and this tool makes. Before and after, before and after. Now you have no distractions on the top left or bottom left of your frame. Everything looks very nice and clean, and you can finally start enjoying your photo, start your editing, start your color grading, start your corrections, and you can now go out, enjoy the photo, print it, do whatever you want with it, post it on social media, and everything is going to look excellent. So that, Saddam, that was it for today. Let's go for a fantastic outro and let's see what you can do after you have seen this lesson and how you can take advantage of this information to correct your very own photos within Affinity Photo. Okay, that was it. I hope it was useful. I hope you managed to get some nice techniques that you can use on your own photos. You can download this photo from the link below, don't forget that, so you can follow along with this tutorial. And if you have any questions, please let me know in the comments below. I would be more than happy to answer to every and each one of them. And also make sure to subscribe to our newsletter, because we send once per week all our free tutorials into a very nice newsletter, so you don't miss a thing. Finally, if you like content like this and if you like Affinity Photo, please subscribe to our YouTube channel, because we're going to be constantly publishing tutorials like this one for Affinity Photo and more. So stay tuned for our next tutorials. This is Stratos Agiani signing out, and until next time, take care. Thank you very much for your time and see you later. Ciao!